I would like to thank Ms. Marche Hyland, Deshaun's mother, for raising this child. And for strongly encouraging him to come to St. George's. When I think about what it was like to know Bones when he was in high school, the thing that stands out to me the most is his will, determination, and laser focus on accomplishing his dreams. During his senior year, I put together a book study that included him and four other young men. We chose to read The Boys of Gumball. In that book served as the catalyst for many conversations about life. I took it upon myself to encourage each young man in that study to start thinking about what his future plans were. And when it came time for Bones to share his future plans, without hesitation, he told me he was headed to the NBA and he was going to take care of his family and his community. Now, I've come across more than one young man whose high school dream is to play professional sports. So I gently encouraged him to develop a plan B. He told me there is no plan B. He is headed to the NBA and he will take care of his family and his community. So again, I'm an educator, so I try to take a different route. I asked him, okay, are you going to college? He said, yes. What do you want to major in? He replied, yes, I'm going to college. I want to major in whatever is going to help me get to the NBA, take care of my family, and my community. Not only did I clearly learn that day that there was no plan B, but this is a kid who was so dedicated to achieving his plan A that nothing could stop him, regardless of the obstacles he had already faced and those that were awaiting him in the future. That steadiness and single-mindedness separated him from his peers. He was driven. He was determined. As he approached every decision in his life with a clear vision of where he was going to end up. Everyone here tonight gets to celebrate the fact that a kid from Bloomington, Delaware was able to beat the odds stacked against him to achieve his dreams. Congratulations, Bones. I couldn't be prouder of the young man that you were and the man that you have become. As I've watched your career continue skyrocketing, I'm so proud of the fact that you have retained the same character you've always exhibited, and that you've never let basketball control you. Rather, you used basketball to get you to those dreams, to those goals that you told me when we were in the principal's conference room. You wanted to use your talent to take care of your family and your community. Congratulations on doing exactly what you set out to do. We are so proud of you, and we can't wait to watch the rest of your future unfold. Thank you. Love you.
Thank you. that's a big responsibility. And I know it's one that you are proudly aware of. So it's uplifting to me when I look at my kids throughout the city. And I know they're running around in the right place. And people like you are rare and you're important to our communities. So look, my last message to you is this. Elton Brand gave me two courtside tickets tomorrow, so I want you to kick it tomorrow now, right? Okay? I said, how are you going to manage that? How are you going to put all that together? He said, well, that's too short. I said, well, I have an idea of how we can do it, or how you can do it. But the most important thing is that you can never lose your love of the game. It's always got to be burning inside you. It's always got to be there. You always got to put your finger on it, be able to identify with it. Never give up despite of whatever comes and adversity that you go through. I said, can you do that? He paused. He said, I think I can. I said, then why are you sitting here? Why don't you go work on it? He said, yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to work on it. And you going to be here when I get back? I said, no, I'm going to go with you. Keep my eye on you. See if you make the right decisions and do various things that you need to do. You got a lot of people, a lot of mouths to feed. Are you aware of that? He said, yeah. I said, so you're willing to give yours and your help to them? He said, yeah. So I just stopped paying today to let you know that the love of the game got us all sitting down here in St. George's. And it's a beautiful city. Thank you.
At this time, I'd like to bring you to stage the lady of the hour, Mrs. Marche Hyland.
Been everywhere, okay? And keeps him focused. Like I told him a long time ago, it's not about him. God gave him this gift, and that's why he's here, and that's why he excels the way he does. So we always give God the glory. So I say, he is a trendsetter. He is a go-getter. He is a record breaker. We don't got no limits. Whatever you want to do, you can achieve. We don't put no limits on nothing. We don't. So I just want to say thank you. Thank you for coming out. I want to speak to the mothers and the fathers out here. Stay in your children's business. Be mindful who they're around, okay? We live in a day and age where there's a lot of stuff going on. And he couldn't go anywhere. He couldn't be around anybody. He couldn't be at the party and stuff. You had to keep him, had to keep his gift protected. And that's how we got here. Don't stop speaking life to your children. I don't care if it looks like they're not listening. You keep speaking to your children. And you keep planting those seeds, because those seeds are growing. And don't get discouraged. Thank you again. And that's all I got. I love y'all.
Next thing I said, get back in the gym, son. And the rest is history, ladies and gentlemen. So proud of this young man right here. I'm just so proud of him. And sometimes I would just be looking at the game and I would tell college coaches, I said, hey, listen, Bones put cheeks in the seat. Look at his house tonight. He puts cheeks in the seats. So all my teammates came in, Michigan, UConn, Maryland, but VCU stuck with it for 2 years. J.D. Byers said to me, he said, Coach, I'm getting a little word. I said, why? He said, Seton Hall is here, Michigan is here, UConn is here. I said, J.D., you put in the work. Don't worry. Bones went on a visit, a few visits. But when he called me from VCU, he said, Coach, I said, how you doing, Bones? He said, I love it. I said, that's where he's going. And he went to the right place. And recruiting is not, you got to make sure that they need you, not want you. And they need him, and he paid his dues. So from this point forward, I would tell you nobody else would wear number 5 in the history of St. George's basketball. This young man has earned this. So this what you see here is not a reward for winning championships. It's a reward for the hard work he's put in to get where he's at. And the journey continues. So this picture of black. The black number 5 is going up on the wall in St. George's. And on the bottom of the picture, 2019 championship. This white, I don't know how you're going to get it back to Denver, but the white jersey belongs to you. And the picture is the picture of the 1,000 point at the Governor's Challenge. Over here, this is, I got some pictures from Bones. I said, well, I got to choose some. So this one says Bones, and his tattoo is Busy Bones in Wilmington. I think everybody's seen that. And over here, the third picture is the VCU coaching staff and the St. George's coaching staff from the draft night. And that'll stay here in our gym. So ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let's get together. Let's get DJ Willie.
The things that matter most happen right in our own backyard, our neighbors, our schools, the places we go, and the people we know. And now there's one news outlet where our story is told. Delaware Live. Locally owned, community-based news. Free to every reader, because Delaware's future belongs to all of us. Quality journalism we can trust to help us take on the day. Delaware Live. Our state, our news, our home.